or record the session and share with us after the call. Maybe
We
after.
will do that. All the sessions that you are attending here, we record them and we share them with you, but they come with some limited validity of 1 month. You know,
Okay.
in that time frame, you should be able to watch it and complete it, because it doesn't make any sense after, you know, watching the same session after 2 months. So,
okay.
Yeah. So that's one more thing we are doing here, that all the sessions that we are taking, we are also recording them, so that, you know, if anyone misses any session, no need to worry, because on the same day you will be receiving the video session, so that you can complete it. Okay. Anything else? Who is next? Like, I mean, your name. I just would like to hear from you. Your name. Where are you working? And why have you chosen this session? Only 3 points, not more than 15, 20 seconds. Who wants to go first?
Hey, hi. This is Harinath. I'm working in a top MNC right now, so I wanted to learn this tool to, you know, understand the macros, Excels, graphs and all, because I promoted as a manager and I wanted to be, you know, make sure I know everything in the Excel sheet. So that's it.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so many things we'll go through today. Yeah.
Hi, this is Bipin. Working in retail organization and being working in retail organization, Excel is a very important tool for us, and that's why I have opted to learn this thing.
Okay, nice, excellent.
Good morning, sir. This is Harinath. I'm working in a MNC and I want to learn macros. And I want to brush up my Excel skills. So for that reason, I'm joining this course.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Who's next?
Hi, this is Mansi. Right now I'm pursuing CIMA. And since I was not aware, I was not known with the skills of Excel, and I wanted to study it.
Okay, yeah, thank you.
Yeah, hi, this is Wonfi. Yeah, I am working with some MNC, actually, and in an IJP process. I want to learn Excel and SQL.
I am Rajesh. Hello.
Yeah,
I'm Rajesh. Right now I'm working in top MNC company. I want to know the about Excel skills and skills and functions and programming in Excel. So that's the reason I joined in Excel.
Rajesh, do I know you by any chance?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Who is next?
Hi. I'm Ramesh. Currently, I'm working in the marketing field. So I want to change my career. So to in data analyst. So that is the reason I chose this course.
Okay. You want to become a data analyst? Excellent.
Yeah. Your good name, please.
I'll come to my introduction in a bit once you are done. Okay.
Thank you.
Hi, this is Naresh. I'm working with a top MNC company. So Excel helps to grow in my career. So that's why I want to learn Excel.
Learn Excel. Thank you. What's next? Okay, let's take the introduction from offline participants also, if you could.
Hi, my name is Ali. I work for Genpact for 3 years, where I was into accounts payable and US payroll services. I'm an MBA graduate, so I want to excel in Excel, you know, to build my caliber in this domain. So I came up here with a lot of enthusiasm. Really helpful for being a commerce student, being into financial accounting process team. Without Excel, I cannot do anything. So Excel is like an ocean, so we need to learn as much as we can. So my aim is to be part of this institute and do something professionally as well as personally for growth. Thank you. That's all about me.
Thank you. Who's next?
Mm-hmm. MIS executive, and you want to learn Excel, okay?
Yeah.
Hey.
So basically you want to report, you want to prepare reports in short time, right? Okay. Spending, yeah, got your point. Okay. Cool. Yep. Okay. Payroll related. Excellent. Yeah, that's right. Payroll related things most of the times. I mean, yeah, we work with so many numbers there. Yeah. Online, anyone left?
No, sir, we are there.
Anyone left? I mean, I'm mean to say, anyone yet to share the introduction? Okay. I think everyone is done. I'm sure, but yeah. Anyways, I'll take you through the presentation. There, I can talk more about myself. Most of you are here to learn the reporting stuff, right? Be it, you know, payroll related reporting or MIS reporting or any kind of reporting. Just a second. Ultimately, you know, when we want to do something, it comes to Excel, okay? Because all the data that you handle within Excel, though this data is available in various ERP tools, ultimately we export all of them into Excel, and there we prepare reports using, you know, formulas, pivot tables, and so many things, right? So Excel turned out to be a very important tool. You know, it's just not limited to only one domain or one company or you know, one specific area. It's everywhere. If you are into sales, if you are into finance, if you are into marketing, it doesn't really matter. Ultimately, we all need to work with Excel. Right? Most of us, we think that Excel is something, you know, if we input a couple of numbers here and there and apply the borders and changing the background colors is what Excel. I mean, most of us, we think, I mean, even I used to think in the same way when I was in graduation, that merging something, wrapping text are the greatest features of Excel. But there are so many other things, you know, most of us, we say usually that Excel is an ocean, right? But what we can share here, we may not be able to share the entire ocean of information, but we can definitely share something that you can easily sail through that ocean. Okay, so that's what we have been doing from the last close to 7 years. By this 15th of March, it's going to be 7 years we started Excelitics. The intention behind starting this one is to make people aware the power of Excel actually, because using Excel, you can build one ERP system itself, right? And it's just not a reporting tool. Along with reporting, you can do a lot of things using programming as well. That is what I'm going to cover in macros, okay? A few of you rightly mentioned you want to build your career in data analytics, okay? Data analytics these days, you hear a lot, like you go anywhere, people talk about data and analyzing the data. So there are so many tools available, you know, when it comes to data analysis, you can take Tableau, you can take Power BI, you can take, okay? And coming to Click, you have a Click View, ClickSense there. You know, all these things are basically to analyze the data with visualization. You know, data visualization kind of concepts are there in these tools, but Excel is a little different. It can handle data as well as a little bit of calculations you can do, not little bit, actually you can do extensive calculations also. And after that, you can also visualize the data right from basic data handling to how to prepare a dashboard. All those things are there, okay? Most of us in our report, you know, in our offices, what we do is that we prepare simple reports, right? Simply showing a table with a few percentages here and there, okay? Last year it was like this, this year it's like this. We do comparison analysis and all. We present them in simple table formats and all. But using Excel itself, we can create beautiful dashboards, okay? As part of this session, we're going to go through all those things, like right from the data fundamentals to how to prepare a dashboard. Up to that level, we will learn. And yeah, so there is a question, data analytics and data analysts, is there any difference? Not actually. People who do data analytics are called data analysts. I mean, it's a designation. Data analytics is a domain and data analyst is a designation. And again, you know, companies, they offer this designation basis on the kind of roles that they do, right? And the roles and responsibilities that they handle. Someone who is more into preparing periodic reports, weekly reports, daily reports, monthly reports, they're either called MIS analyst, MIS executive, or MIS someone, right? But people who deal with a lot of data, you know, come up with insights, right? Understand the data and come up with insights, actionable insights, they are called analysts, data analysts, financial data analysts. If you are into more into finance side, financial data analysts. If you are into HR data analyst, something like that. But ultimately, good thing is that we all work with data, right? So let me quickly take you through why data analytics are needed and how Excel plays its role there, okay? I'll anyway share all these presentations with you for your understanding purpose. Okay, even if something is not so clear, you can ask me questions. And if you would like to take a look at this presentation again, I'll share these presentations with you. You can go through. Okay, so this is basically about me. I'm Kishore. It's been close to 13 years. You know, I started my career with various companies. I worked with iHealth Technologies, United Health Group, a good number of companies I worked with, okay? All this while I've been working with the data analytics roles only, okay? But for the first 1.5 years, I worked with a data entry profile, but after that, rest everything, like almost 11.5 years, I've been working with data analytics and reporting only. So that first 1.5 years, what I learned is that in the data entry process is, you know, what kind of mistakes can be done at the data entry level. So if you are clear about that, your data analysis becomes very much easier, yes or no? See, if you are looking at the data, you want to analyze the data, but you are not able to figure out what went wrong in the data. It's like really difficult to analyze the data. But my, you know, good thing is here is that for me, I started my career as a data entry operator. So in that one, I understood what kind of mistakes are done at the data entry level. So if you are aware of those things, the moment you get some data, you can easily understand that, oh, okay, so in this one, this data is not looking right because of XYZ reasons, right? So that's how I started. But later I moved into, you know, I used to work with US healthcare. So So that's after that I moved into physician performance analytics. We used to analyze the hospital's data, doctor's data especially. And then I moved to UHG, United Health Group, and there I worked as an automation expert. You know, my education background, BCom MBA. BCom MBA, automation expert. I mean, doesn't really actually match, right? So most of the people think that automation expert sounds so you know, so technical. And how you could crack that role? It's because VBA, it's visual basic for applications. It's macros we call in Excel. We can automate something. So I'm good with VBA. So they offered me that role. And I used to work with 29 different processes, okay, to automate their requirements. Okay. I spent around 2 years and later moved to a different company. And there I spent about a good number of 6 years. And right from the beginning of my career, I've been with the data. Okay. So this is what I say. You can attend, you know, any kind of an interview. For that one, you just need to have a little bit of domain knowledge and more about data knowledge. Why? Because you go anywhere, data is data. You see text, you see numbers, you see, you know, logicals, you see errors. Okay. It's everywhere the same. It's just that you need to understand that domain a little. That's it. You can perform. You can become HR data analyst or financial data analyst or a normal data analyst, MIS analyst. And ultimately, we all work with data. That's it. Right? Clear? Perfect. So let me take you through this. Yeah, before that, let me tell you about a couple of other points about me. That's I'm a Microsoft certified professional. I'm a Six Sigma certified. I'm a certified internal auditor by ISO. So these are my certifications. I work with Excel, macros, SQL, SAP Business Objects, Business Intelligence, SAP Crystal Reports, ClickView, a bit of Tableau, and I started looking into Power BI as well. Okay, these are the different tools I use. So you name, you know, any data analytical tool, I have at least worked for like some part of it. Okay, but coming to Excel, macros, SQL, these are the common skill set that is needed for any data analyst. But if you're starting as a beginner into data analyst, definitely these are the skills you will have to acquire. So anyways, I'm going to talk about those things. What all skills are needed to become a data analyst? Okay, so why data analysis? I don't think I need to tell this one for this group because most of you are working professionals here, I assume. Anyone here who is not a working professional? Anyone online? You can use the chat window. Anyone here not a working professional? No idea about it? Okay, cool, no issues. All right, so why data analysis? It's all about analyzing the data, right? In that one, there may be different stages of gathering the data, how you transform that into information, and then what are the different techniques you will use to present that data? So various things are there, but why do we need to analyze the data? What is data analysis? Simple. Earlier, these decisions were made intuitively, but later everything turned out to be a data-driven decision. Okay, so I'll tell you a simple thing. Let's take an example of bus ticket prices, okay? Earlier, people used to get the bus ticket, prices like a standard price, right? But these days, have you observed, like if you want to travel over a weekend, the price fluctuates, right? Because they know that even though the price is increased, the customer will be ready to pay for it. You know why? Because of the data that they tracked in last 5-6 years, right? So they check how many times, you know, the customers are traveling and over a weekend, how many of them are traveling. And they also have a little bit of credit profile of those customers, how much they can afford to pay. All those things is now more like a customized, you know, pricing models we see. Okay. You know, you can check your Flipkart online, you know, marketing also online app as well. But the prices that are visible for you may not be the same prices for me. The offers that you get may not be the same offers for me. Same app. You see that much of level of, you know, customization is happening these days. But how? Data, right? So So they maintain each and every customer data, and then basis on that they prepare a small program. You know, everything is like artificial intelligence these days. Okay, they prepare a small program and it will check, okay, this person would be interested in this particular thing by next month, so let me push a notification to this person saying, okay, that there is a 15% off going on, go for it. You getting it? So everything is data driven, individual targeting. Yes. See, n number of things. These days, everything is data-driven. I'll tell you one more thing. Let's take an example of some production. Water bottle production. A simple example, okay? If you go to a shop, you will get a water bottle, right? But that water bottle is there in that shop. You know why? At least 1 week ago, someone anticipated that there would be a demand for this water bottle in Amirpet location. That's when they produce it, right? But how can they say that, okay, there would be some demand in the Amirpet location? See, basis on the number of sales, how many, you know, people are living there, you know, how many are frequently visiting the shops, how many of them are buying these water bottles frequently, right? That demand, how much we need to supply, all those things are again numbers driven. Understand this. So if you are going, you know, somewhere and buying something and that product is available there in that shop, that means someone well in advance, 1 month ago, could anticipate the demand for that product in that shop. Yes or no? Right, but how come someone can take that much accurate decisions? Data, right? So we'll talk about all those things. A simple examples I gave, of course, I can talk more into technical also, but I don't want to confuse you now. I'll take you through each and every step of data analysis using Excel tool. You know, these six stages of data analytics you see in any tool. Any tool, but here we are going to learn Excel. Okay, in Excel, these are the six stages we are going to cover. Okay, first of all, we understand data, because for data analysis, what is the one that is needed? Data, right? What is data and how to transform the data into information? Because if you see the raw data, you can't actually understand what is it. So how to transform that into information using Excel formulas and all? There are so many advanced formulas we'll look into. And then the information is ready, then how to summarize the data. Okay, how to summarize the data, then how to present the data. Presentation in terms of, you know, we prepare a dashboard. I'll show you an example here, what kind of dashboard we prepare. I'm just showing one of my old batches file here. Yeah. So we prepare something like this. Okay, we try to analyze, okay, 2012 office supplies and especially labels and papers, how are they? What kind of profit we got? How is the trend of those things? Okay, we prepare this kind of a dashboard. Okay, right from the scratch, from a blank page, a blank worksheet to like this. But there are a few fundamentals you will have to learn before preparing a dashboard. So we spend some time to understand those fundamentals, and then we prepare a dashboard. And along with that, other couple of examples are also there. Something like an assessment dashboard. Okay, so how to create templates and all, you will get some idea by looking at this one. You see this one, these are looking like buttons, right? So you are switching from one tab to the other tab. Yeah, you see this, you want to know level two assessment scores, how they are, and especially in the month of August or July, okay, I think months are not there. Territory three, how are the percentages, or territory two? You see these things, right? So something like students' performance dashboard, okay? So I'll show you the techniques how you can create these kind of beautiful dashboards. Okay, right. So that's what we do in the presentation part. Okay, we prepare various different charts, charts fundamentals, what is a chart, which type of chart should be used for what. You know, most of us, what we think is that any chart can be used for anything. No, there are, you know, charts, different charts are there and you need to follow those rules. Something like if you want to perform the comparisons, we use the column charts, bar charts. Okay, if you want to show the compositions, the you know percentage of allocation, things like that. We use a pie chart, a donut chart. Okay. Yeah. And if you want to show something related to the timeline, okay, how the performance is over last year. Okay. So we use a line chart. So different types of charts are there. We talk about that, and using all those fundamental rules of charts, we prepare a dashboard. It's all about data visualization. And then analyze. Once the dashboard is ready, then how to analyze to take better decisions. Okay, so we'll do that. And finally, before sharing, we protect it or we print it the last few stages. Okay, so all these things are there with each and every tool. And don't limit your knowledge only to Excel, because these are the stages available with Tableau, ClickView, Power BI, whatever you do, same things we do. Okay, first of all, we spend some time on the data, understand the data and how to transform that into information. Once the information is ready, how to summarize that data, and then how to present using a dashboard and analyze the data. Finally, we print our product. These are the six different stages we do. Okay, and then a few of you might get a question about what kind of roles I get, because if I'm learning this advanced Excel course, then what kind of roles I'm going to get. These are like, you know, there are various roles like data scientists, data engineers, data analysts, but I don't want to talk about data scientists and engineers because it also requires extra skill set. But when it comes to data analysts, we all can become easily data analysts, because the first skill set that is needed is Excel to become data analyst. And by the way, this is something created not by us. We picked up one of the job offering site, and in which they mentioned the source is at the end. I'll show you from where we captured it. So these guys say that Excel, Tableau, SQL, in this position Tableau, you can replace it either with ClickView or Power BI, because Tableau, ClickView, Power BI are the data visualization tools only. Anyone, you can go for it. And these days, if you ask me, Power BI playing you know, a better role than ClickView and Tableau because of this price effectiveness, because it's very cheap compared to Tableau or ClickView. Power BI is like hardly $10 per license per month. But others are like, you know, if you want to buy a 1 year license, it's into, you know, lakhs, Indian rupees, lakhs, okay? So you also need to have SQL. This is what I'm trying to tell you. These are the basic skill set required for any data analyst, Excel, any one of the visualization tool like Tableau, ClickView, Power BI, and SQL. Okay, structured query language, because you want to get the data from the databases. Okay, good question. So SQL and PLSQL, are they same, or do I need to learn both of them, or are they different? So many questions are there. But again, coming to SQL for the data analyst role, we don't need PLSQL, okay? So PLSQL, we can do the programming, okay? Wherein you can create stored procedures, functions you can create. You can do so many things with the PLSQL, but we don't want that. We just need SQL for reporting analytics. So the course that we introduced also only for the reporting and analytics, okay? We have an SQL course, and it specially talks about SQL for reporting and analytics, because in SQL also, as a data analyst, you don't get a chance to work with DDL or DML. DDL, data definition language, DML, data manipulation language. Both of them we don't do. Data definitions is all about how you prepare a table, okay? What kind of columns are needed, you know, those kind of things. Before storing the data, you need to prepare the definition of the table, data definition language. DML, data manipulations. How to insert a new record, how to update a record, how to delete a record. Record is nothing but one entry, okay? But as a data analyst, we don't do either of them. We don't deal with DDLs, we don't deal with DMLs. What is that we do? We deal with only select queries. Select queries are for to extract the data from the databases. As a reporting analyst, I just need to know how to extract the data. I no need to know how to insert the data, how to update the data, how to delete the data, basically how to manipulate the data. I don't need to know. I just need to know if there are multiple tables, how to join the tables and, you know, extract only the required amount of data. Because when you talk about a database, it consists of so many tables. and I want to analyze the, you know, last 1 month sales information. Okay. But the database consists of maybe last 10 years information. I don't need 10 years information. Just need only last 1 month information belongs to one particular store. Okay. To get that data, you need to write SQL queries. You need to know that SQL query so that you can execute that one and extract the required set of data and you can start analyzing the data. Okay, so that's how the data gathering is done. And usually what happens, you know, with big companies, they will have a dedicated SQL team. What you need to do is that you just need to write a request to them saying that I want to analyze so-and-so data, please share me this data. So what they do, they write the query, they execute it on the database, and they share the data back so that you can use the data in Excel, prepare pivot tables, you know, formats, and whatever you do, and you present that one using a dashboard. Okay. But most of the companies these days, they're expecting this SQL skill set also from reporting analyst only. Why? Because you no need to write a request to SQL team and wait for a couple of days to, you know, come back with the data, right? You no need to wait for that. If the data analyst or reporting analyst has that SQL skill set, we only can write it. I mean, it's not like rocket science. It's like very easy, okay? So that's the reason the SQL queries also turned out to be, kind of very important for a data analyst role, okay? So for this particular course, we can talk about data analysts and in that one, how Excel plays its role, okay? And coming to the types of data analytics, we can promise here the descriptive analytics and diagnostic analytics, okay? Not the predictive analytics and prescriptive analytics, because this also requires a lot of domain knowledge and, you know, so many other things are needed. So what is descriptive analytics? What's happening in the business? And this is what you can easily do using Excel. Okay, so basically you get the data, you prepare it. Yeah, I'm getting questions, I'll respond to them one by one. So descriptive analytics is something you can easily do them with Excel, because you get the data, you will have standard templates, okay? And it tells us like, how is the performance? How is the last month performance? This month performance? How is the comparison percentages? What's happening, you know? Easily you can say that one using Excel. Diagnostic also you can easily achieve using Excel. Why is it happening? Because you see some downtrend, uptrend, okay? If something is going good, why is it happening like this? If something is going down, you know, why is it happening like this? These two things you can easily achieve using Excel. And we'll talk about all those things in Excel, okay? I may be talking about a high-end overview of data analytics, but I'll relate all these points with Excel in a bit, okay? Don't get confused. I'm getting questions from you like, you know, I'm a beginner and I don't have absolutely any idea about data analytics, and you're talking so many things. But when I relate these things with Excel, you can easily understand them, okay? What's happening, why it's happening. Using Excel, I can show you both of them. But predictive, what likely to happen in future? You will have to build models. For that predictive analysis, you will have to depend on other few languages too. And prescriptive analytics, and what do I need to do? Corrective measures. If something is not going good, then how to control that, right? But from this course, you can expect descriptive and diagnostic. I'll show you how to achieve them, okay? So job opportunities, definitely a good number of opportunities are there in the market. Using Excel itself, you know, you can become a data analyst, and packages are also very high compared to the others. Okay, someone who is into operations for 3 to 4 years, okay, operations, maybe business of BPO operations or any other kind of operations, if their pay is 3 lakh after 2 to 3 years of experience, and this data analyst after 2 to 3 years of experience, the package is around 5 to 6 lakh. Okay, packages are also so nice. If you want to become a data analyst, the first 4 skills are needed. Okay, a complete data analyst. If you want to become MIS analyst or MIS executive and all, advanced Excel is enough. But if you want to progress in your career, towards data analyst. This is a career path. You need to start with advanced Excel, VBA macros, SQL, Access RDBMS. Okay, any RDBMS you need. But at least for now, you can focus on these two, advanced Excel and macros. Okay, so using advanced Excel itself, you can get the, you know, jobs in the MIS roles, data related roles. But using VBA macros, you can automate your work. I'll also show you an example what is, okay, VBA macros. All right, so the next two are SQL and Access RDBMS. These are basically about, you know, databases, relational database management systems, okay? Why? Because as a data analyst, I need to work with what data. But where this data exists, it exists in a database. So that means I need to know how to interact with the database and gather the required amount of data and start analyzing it, right? That's why this skill set is also needed. But even if you don't have this skill set, using advanced Excel skill set, you can get a job, or advanced Excel with VBA macros also you will get a job. And as I told you, VBA macros, if you have, you can also get into a technical role. Okay. As I said, automation expert is a technical role actually, but using VBA macros, you can achieve that. Okay. So I think path-wise, you guys are clear,
yes.
Right? So I think as you are already working somewhere and you want to improve your skill set with Excel, but just not limit yourself only to your company requirements and all, right? If you learn more, you can actually look out for a good number of opportunities, right? Yeah, coming to the questions, like if I'm very new, then can I learn all these things? Okay, we started from scratch, and I'll also show you the difference between basic Excel and advanced Excel now, so that you will get some idea. Because most of the, you know, participants, they would like to usually know that, you know, what is the difference between basic Excel and advanced Excel. We'll start it from there, then you will get some clarity, okay? And request you to start some working. Never end. Okay, I got your point, Sacha, but as we are in the introduction, kind of an awareness session on these things, I'm just talking about all those things that gives a clear idea about what is that you are going to learn in these sessions. That's why.
So one quick question.
Yes, please.
Maybe, yeah. Are we going to learn all this stuff what you have shown in the PPT, or maybe it's limited to some of the topics?
So this particular course is going to cover advanced Excel, and if you would like to go for VBA macros in the same batch, we are going to continue VBA macros as well, right?
Okay.
Yeah, there is another question. Okay, so first of all, let me complete this one. So we're going to cover these two things in this particular batch, and if you are more interested towards getting into a complete data analyst role, then you will also have to learn SQL, Access RDBMS. And you also want to go towards visualization, creating dashboards and all, go for Tableau, Power BI, or ClickView. See, these are the steps. Few of the participants, why we created this flow, because a few of the participants, without knowing SQL, they directly join SQL. Okay? I mean, without knowing the importance of SQL and why is it needed, where is it needed. Few of the colleagues or few of their seniors, they suggest that, okay, go learn SQL because the data analyst require SQL. But wait, yes, I agree, data analyst position requires SQL. But when you should learn it, once you are good with advanced Excel,
yeah.
Right? Without knowing the reporting environment, there is no point directly learning SQL. If you directly learn SQL, you can't understand how the data is used in reporting. But if you use the data in reporting and you know how it looks like, what kind of calculations you can do, how you prepare a report, if you know them, then interacting with the database will give you some idea. Okay, in this database, the data is stored in this way. And if I want to report this one, I need to get this data into Excel in this way. That will get some idea. But if someone directly would like to go for Power BI, we say no. There is no point directly learning Power BI without understanding Excel first. Right? So the concepts that we talk in Power BI, that person may not be able to understand because that person is new to reporting. Right? So these are the different steps you need to go through if you want to go towards ultimately a data scientist role wherein you'll be working with machine learning and artificial intelligence, right? These are the steps you will have to complete, okay? No need to depend on my words. You can search in any, you know, website also. This is what they also suggest, okay? they may not work specifically about Excel, but as a working professional and got some good experience in the real time, I know how Excel plays its role. You go any company, it is just impossible to find a company without Excel. Yes or no? You go to any company, be it industry, any manufacturing company also, they ultimately need to work with Excel. There is no other way. And if you are good with those techniques, and you can save a lot of time. You can prepare beautiful dashboards, reports, so many things. And there is a question, it's about you teach only Excel or you are advanced Excel? Good one. Let me ask you this question to others. Which one you want? You want Excel or you want advanced Excel?
Advanced Excel.
Advanced Excel. Right, all of you? Online, could you please respond to this question, please? Would you like to learn Excel here or advanced Excel here?
Excel and advanced Excel.
Excel and advanced Excel. Cool. Okay.
I think both are same.
Both are same. Okay.
If you cover this advanced Excel, automatically the basic Excel will be covered.
Yes. Right, okay. So I think a few of you definitely have this question about what is basic Excel and what is advanced Excel, right? So let's do a small exercise. With that, you will get some idea what is basic Excel and what is advanced Excel. And after that, you can take a call which one you want to learn, okay? And really, would you like to know the difference between basic Excel and advanced Excel before we start the session?
Yes, sir.
You are already having some idea. Can you teach Excel also? Yeah, you are saying like, okay, we want to know basic Excel and advanced Excel. So let me do one thing. This side is basic Excel. This is advanced Excel. Let's try to understand basic Excel and advanced Excel, and then we'll take a call which one to learn, okay? I totally understand that there are few beginners, especially no idea about what is this, what is Excel and all. I'll also talk about that one, but do one thing. I'll ask you a few questions about formulas of Excel or features of Excel. You need to tell me whether that is a basic Excel feature or advanced Excel feature. Okay? Yeah. So let's try this. All of you are ready? I'll be asking questions about a few features, okay? Or few functions. You need to tell me whether that is basic one or advanced one. All right, online, you are ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's proceed then. Opening Excel file, is it basic one or advanced one? Opening Excel workbook, basic one or
basic? Basic.
Basic one. Saving Excel file? Basic.
Basic.
File. Printing is also basic. Okay, save as Excel file.
Basic.
Save as a PDF or save as? Save as basic, and few of you are saying advanced. That's okay. I'll write both of them, okay? Feel free to say that whatever you feel, okay? Right? Don't depend on others. If you want to say something as advanced, say advanced, okay? Writing a sum formula, SUM.
Advanced.
Basic.
Advanced.
Okay. A few of you are saying it is advanced. That's okay. Average formula? Basic. All of you? Average formula. Writing an average formula in Excel.
Okay.
Online?
Basic. Okay. Only basic.
All right. VLOOKUP formula?
Advanced.
All of you?
Yes, advanced.
Advanced, okay. Fine. You know, VLOOKUP, if you say advanced, I can directly write HLOOKUP also advanced. All of you agree with this one?
Yeah.
Yeah, HLOOKUP is also advanced. You know, there is another formula, index and match combination. A few of you might have heard this.
Advanced.
Yeah.
Index plus match.
Better than VLOOKUP. Okay, there is a formula called index and match, which works.
Yeah.
So definitely this is also advanced. Okay, pivot table.
Advanced.
All right, advanced. Conditional formatting is something that allows you to color something with a condition. Advanced. If something is greater than 50,000.
Advanced,
okay. Inserting a chart, prepare a simple column chart.
Advanced.
Graphics means. Yeah, we have so many things. Yeah, we'll talk about that one. Okay. So let me ask you one more thing. Removing duplicates feature. What is that, Chetan? Basic or advanced?
Advanced.
Basic.
Advanced.
Okay, I hear both of them, basic and advanced. SUMIF formula, S-U-M-I-F.
Advanced.
Advanced.
You can do with the condition.
All formulas are advanced.
Okay, all formulas are advanced. Okay. You mean to say that
all if sum if count is
all if formulas
if not if or
right? Okay, yeah. Ashok, I see your question. Can you teach Excel also? I think you mean to say that it is basic Excel, right from the scratch. Is my understanding correct, Ashok? You are expecting this one from the scratch? Yes. Yeah. We'll come to that point. Okay, I think a good number of things that we mentioned here. I think with this you are able to understand the difference between basic and advanced, or you have still some question. We are not so clear. Okay. Okay. Here's the point. Even though we did this exercise, we are not so clear about which one, why we are calling something as basic and why we are calling something as advanced. Few of you said, few features are basic and few features are advanced, but we are really not sure why that is categorized under basic and why that is categorized under advanced. Here's the answer. On the left-hand side, you look at the basic things. Open, save, print, save as, sum, average, removing duplicates, right? You know how to do them? How to save a book? How to open a workbook? How to take a printout of a workbook? Online, do you know that? How to do that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay, so on the advanced side, it says VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, index match, pivot table, conditional formatting, charting. Let me ask you this question. How frequently you do these things? How frequently preparing a pivot table? How frequently writing index and match formula, VLOOKUPs? Rarely, right? Or maybe never. Right? Have you ever worked with?
Never.
Index and match, never. And few of you, it might sound a very new thing. At least you have absolutely no idea what is it. VLOOKUP, no idea what is it? Yes? I think now I gave you a clue to understand the difference between basic and advanced. Any guess?
Whenever we are using the formulas, if we use formulas, then it's advanced Excel.
Okay, if you use formula, then it is advanced. Okay, if we use sum formula, sum, is it an advanced one?
It's a basic action.
It's a basic one, right? Okay. Let me reveal the fact here. The difference between basic Excel and advanced Excel. Things that you know, you're calling them basic. Things that you don't know, you're calling them advanced. Yes? One of the participants said sum is an advanced formula because that participant never worked or might have, never worked on that one or felt, maybe that is little complex to write a sum formula. But if I ask you, sum formula, is it a basic one or advanced one? You say that it is
basic.
Most of you say that basic because we know how to write it. Yes, but few of the participants, they said, okay, sum is an advanced one because they have never worked, that they are very new to Excel. How to work with it? Absolutely no idea. You're getting it. Now tell me the difference between basic Excel and advanced Excel.
Uh,
What are the options regularly? I mean, the person, not only for the individual. So we are not using that. Mm-hmm. So then they felt that it's a advanced level for from point of their end.
Yep. To make it a simple statement, things that you know is basic. Things that you don't know is advanced. That's it. If you ask me, I'm not here to talk about basic Excel or advanced Excel. I'm here to talk about only Excel. If you want to treat it as basic, you treat it as basic. If you want to treat it as advanced, you treat it as advanced. I'll leave it to you. I'll leave it to you. And the amount of practice that you do, all these features will sound like basic for you. But if you don't do practice, all these things sound advanced forever. Yes or no? Right? So my promise for this batch is by end of this Excel session, you all will feel like Excel is basic. Why? Because by the time you will learn all those Excel features, whatever I take you through. We'll also give you enough exercises. Okay. We'll also create one WhatsApp group. There you can initiate a conversation about a particular feature that you are struggling with. Our team will help you, or any one of the other participants from the same group can help you. Okay, so in this 1 month, it's almost like one 4 weekends course, Excel. Okay, in this 1 month, 4 weekends, we're going to start from the scratch of Excel. I started from what is Excel? What is a spreadsheet? That's where we start. You know, first one and a half hour may be a little bit of boring for the ones who are already working with Excel. I understand. I totally understand. But I also need to make sure that there are few new beginners, right, with Excel. They should understand what is Excel. Yeah. So we started from there. But let me tell you one good point here. Even though we started from scratch, in that process, you will learn so many new things about Excel. You may be thinking, okay, I've been working with this Excel from last 5-6 years, and there is no point talking about a spreadsheet. I know what is a spreadsheet, but the way we see Excel and we talk about Excel is little different from the way you see it. Because almost like, you know, all these years I've been working with Excel, and I found so many things which are very minor ones, but they are like little, you know, interesting facts to know about Excel. Okay, we'll also cover those things in the very introduction session of Excel. Right? So that you will also not miss anything, right? So the ones who are really new to Excel, no need to worry. As I'm saying here, we are going to start it from very, very scratch. If we do calculations, then it's advanced. I mean, if you want to take your, understanding about advanced in that way, you go for it, no issues. But if you ask me, even if I write a very complex formula in Excel, I don't call it advanced, because I've been doing from the last close to 14 years, and there is no point of calling something in, you know, something as advanced, you know, after having these many years of experience. Because you give me any complex formula or any complex requirement also, that sounds like basic for me. Right? So there is no basic, there is no advanced. Exactly. It all depends on you. If you want to treat it as basic, treat it as basic. If you don't learn it, forever it is advanced only. Index and match formula, if I give you a 5-minute session about index and match formula, the very next moment you say that index and match formula is a basic one. Because, you know, you will learn that one, right? Okay. So any questions before we start?
Hi, sir. Can I ask my personal question, sir? Hello?
I mean, what?
No, sir. Actually, I am working in Excel and advanced Excel last 5 years. Mm-hmm. But I want to learn more from advanced Excel and advanced Excel, and also VBA.
Mm-hmm.
And also, my friends who suggested me that you can also learn for Power BI also.
Yeah.
Can I go to directly learn in Power BI without an SPL? Is it okay, sir? Definitely learn for SPL also.
Okay. So can I directly learn a Power BI course without SQL, you're asking?
Yeah, sir.
I don't recommend that one, because in Power BI, we analyze the data, and the data comes from database. Okay. If the data you need to get from the databases, and if you don't know how to interact the database, how to interact with the database and extract the data, then how can you visualize the data using Power BI? So that means SQL skill set is definitely needed for either Power BI or Tableau or ClickView. All these three things are very much similar tools. So SQL is definitely needed for Power BI.
Okay, in that way, I'm not learning for VBS. I can also learn for VBL.
VBA is again a separate track. You don't need to have VBA skill set to learn this data visualization. But I'll tell you one thing. Because if you are working with reports, a lot of reports, so you said last 5 years you've been working with a lot of reports. So let's assume that you spend one hour for one of the reports. Okay, you spend 1 hour for one of those reports.
Yeah.
Using VBA, you can get that output in 1 minute.
Yeah, I know, sir. I know VBA, how to work on VBA, and I know, sir. Actually, I already last 2 years back, I learned on VBA. I know how to utilize that VBA for if function and consolidation and loops and for loops.
Mm-hmm.
I know basic idea,
right?
But I am not working on that.
Okay.
So that's why I'm want to learn on VBA.
Okay. So the VBA part, again, you know, if you want to become a Power BI developer, you don't need VBA. But if you want to save some time, because we spend a lot of time on Excel, right? Every day you prepare reports, daily reports, weekly reports, monthly reports, and all. Every time you need to spend one and a half hour to prepare a report, and you just write a VBA macro, VBA program, right? Just click on that button and it will take care of preparing the report for you, right? So VBA definitely is like an added skill. And one more thing is that is the first step towards programming. VBA, because you know, when I talk about Java, C, people may not be comfortable reading those programs, but let me show you a VBA program so that you will get some idea. It's very easy to understand those codes, because those codes, they look like English. Let me show you. You see these codes here?
Yes, did you make up a code of the code?
Okay. These things are the ones, they look like simple English codes. Okay. You can read it like this: workbooks.add, copy, destination, right? This look very much simple, like English. Right, so this programming language is very easy to learn. But if I talk about Java and it shows different keywords and all, it's very difficult to learn. But coming to VBA, it looks like English. And most of the participants, they ask me like, if I want to learn VBA, what is the primary, the basic skill set I need to have? Do I need to have C language skill set and all? I say, no, nothing. If you know English, that's enough, okay? So most of, definitely a few of the participants might have this question, what is VBA, how is it useful and all. I can show that one here. Just a quick example of what is VBA and how it is useful. Okay. You have some customers data here. Every day you get this file. What you need to do, you need to prepare individual customer data files, okay? You need to select first customer, copy that, create a new workbook, paste it, and rename it as ALFKI, and then go save as, okay? Inside the customers folder, Okay, name it as ALFKI. Okay, XLSX, save it. Okay, and then close it and then pick up the next customer. ANATR. Do the same thing. Copy, paste, copy, paste, copy, paste. And by end of this exercise, you should get all those close to 80 customers are there in the data, and you will have to split the data by the customer name. Right. So tell me, how much time do you need to filter one after the other customers and copy paste?
1 hour or 1.5 hours.
Maybe 1 hour, right? And another thing, can you guarantee 100% quality? No, right? See,
not sure. Yeah.
We start, doing this segregation for all the customers, and there are 80 customers. But end of this exercise, you might find only 75. Five may be missing because of the concentration levels. They go off right after some time, and it's like really difficult to maintain that 100% quality. So here, you just click on this button. Click on this button and go back here. It's creating the files, but in which path it is creating, I need to check now. Yeah, in this one, you see this? You look at the speed. Files are getting created there. Same exercise, you know, while I'm talking with you in the back end, it's doing all that work, and 78 customer files are there. All of them are just done in 26 seconds. And all the files are here with 100% quality. You see this?
Yes.
Right? So they can help us in order to speed up our work. Whatever the Excel reporting that you are doing, it will help us to speed up the work. Right? A lot of time saving. And companies also, they look for the time savings only, right? So today you're preparing a report for 1 hour, and if you automate it, and if it turns out to be a 1 minute job, companies, what they think, okay, we got like 59 minutes extra time from this employee. Obviously, right? That's the reason.
Yes, sir. Also, yeah, companies also are looking for that. Actually, I'm looking for another other job. They are asking for, you have any knowledge on VBR, SPL. They are asking for also.
Right.
Things. So That's why I'm.
Definitely a much needed skill set, especially these days, because companies, they want to always go for the cost saving, right? Yeah, quickly they want to get the outputs. And if you know how to code these things, and moreover, this coding is not too technical, it looks like English. You know, why I'm so confident about this one? Because as I said, I'm also not from the technical background. I'm from BCom MBA Finance, right? So it doesn't require any technical skill set to learn VBA. It's a technology for non-technical people, I would say. So anyone can easily learn, right? Maybe after 11 o'clock, I'll talk more about VBA. But for now, I just wanted to show you some idea, because if someone is here just to join Advanced Excel, but I'm giving you a recommendation that if you stop yourself only with Excel, there may be packages for MIS analyst positions and all, maybe a 2.4, 2.5, maybe up to 3 lakh you can get. But someone who has VBA skill set, who can automate, who can speed up the work, who can save the time, their packages are around 4.85 lakh. See, it's very simple. Like, the more skill set you have, the more package you get. Right. So I say this, learn more, earn more. Learn more, you can earn more, right? So again, coming back to this basic Excel, advanced Excel stuff, we started from the scratch, and I'm here to share Excel only, okay? And see Excel as Excel, no basic, no advanced, right? Because if you're saying something as advanced, that means you're not aware of that particular feature. It's not about the complexity of the feature. If you call something as advanced feature because it is really complex, that I understand. But the definition of basic and advanced, from your standpoint, what you are thinking is that if you know something, you are categorizing that as basic. If you don't know something, you are categorizing that as advanced. It's not because of the complexity of the feature. It's because of the limited knowledge that we have about that feature. Right? So, next time you tell them that you are expert in Excel. Not even advanced, you can say them, you are an expert in Excel. right? They call it advanced Excel. It's just that most of the users are not aware of those features. So they simply call it as, okay, are you aware of advanced Excel? In the interviews, the people, they ask, right? Yeah. So advanced Excel, most of the people, they say in this way, but I don't believe in this statement. There is no advanced Excel for me. I really don't see any advanced Excel. But yeah, maybe for the interviewer, you know, from the satisfaction standpoint of the interviewer, you can say, you can tell them, yes, you are good with advanced Excel, or you are expert with Excel, or you can say, maybe I'm 8 out of 10 in Excel. 8 out of 10 is like really high number. I rate myself around 8.5. Anyone ask me, I say 8.5 is my Excel skill set. Because there are so many things we do and so many new features. And if you take the version that we are handling here is the most recent version of Excel. It has got so many things. I'll take you through all those options to give you, you know, some awareness. And I'm using a word here, awareness. You know, I'm not saying I can make you a master in it. You know, becoming a master depends on who? Depends on me or you? Depends on you only. I can talk about that feature. I can talk about where is it used in the real time. I can talk about a couple of real time cases. That gives you only awareness until you practice. If you practice, then you can become a master, right? Don't expect to be masters just by attending the sessions. Not possible. It's just simply impossible unless you do the practice. Okay, I hope most of you agree with this statement. All right, beginners can also learn now at this stage, VBA. Obviously, you know, again, when it comes to VBA, I talk about what is a program. That's where I start. Okay. So any beginner also without having any idea can learn VBA. Right. Coming to the project related works and all, we have a couple of real-time projects. We can share them with you. Okay. The programs are already there and how you want to think about them and how you want to come up with the outputs, it's up to you. Okay. But if you want to be part of any of our real-time projects, okay, because we also support a lot of clients, people reach out to company, reach out to us, you know, asking for different requirements. And if you want to be part of that project, you will have to spend a dedicated 1-2 hours every day. And maybe we can think about that as an option later so that you will also get some idea about working with a real-time, you know, VBA developer. But it depends, but any few projects, if you are looking for just for your practice purpose, we can obviously share them with you. A good number of projects are with us. You know, we worked for, you know, GSK, it's into pharmaceuticals, right? UK based, we delivered a project. Dr. Reddy's, we are in association with them from the last 5 years. We've been delivering projects for them, right? A good number of big companies. I just named only a few, but a good number of companies are there. We are associated with almost like every big company in Hyderabad. I mean, they all can attend virtually also. You know, we have delivered trainings in HSBC, Procter & Gamble, Dr. Reddy's, Tata Advanced Systems, Tata Projects, okay, Tata Consultancy Services. For that matter, we are associated with educational institutes also, Hyderabad Central University, St. Joseph College, Planet Finance Business Schools, Vigyan Business Schools. So good number of colleges are there, good number of companies are there we are associated with. Our team is, you know, team has been delivering trainings, tools, VBA, you know, projects, so many things we have been doing. Right. So I hope that answers your question, Hari. Okay, so let me check you through. The course content. As few of you are, you know, always habituated to hear these words, basic, excellent, advanced, excellent. Even we had to write in the same way, basic Excel and advanced Excel, yeah, just to satisfy your personal feelings. But I don't see anything different here. We first of all start with understand Excel. What is Excel? You know, a few of you had this question. I am a beginner. I don't have any idea about Excel. So understand Excel. And then what is cut, copy, paste, font groups, you know, formatting, number types, data types, okay? And then we'll move on to advanced Excel. There we work with, you know, formulas. Though I'm calling it as advanced Excel just only for that, you know, people, they treat it advanced Excel is something at a next level. So just want to, you know, satisfy that statement I'm saying here, advanced Excel, but this is also normal Excel only. Excel formulas, what is a formula, how to look at the formula, what are the arguments, you know, a number of things we talk about, and then a good number of formulas, close to 100 plus different formulas we take you through in this session, and how they are used in the real time, a couple of examples I can share you with, and then report designing techniques, okay, kind of shapes that we can use, pictures you can use, all related to the designing, and then data, a filter, slicer, options, okay? Report printing techniques. There we talk about how to print a report, what are the different features you can use inside printing, and data management techniques, how to connect with external applications, be it Access database, SQL database, or any cloud database, you can connect, sorting, filtering, advanced filtering, data validation rules. Data protection techniques, there we talk about how to protect a report or a sheet or data, a range of data, how to protect, how to hide the formulas. You know, before sharing with someone, you don't want to show your formulas to that person, then how to do them. A good number of things are there, and the data viewing, how you want to view the report, and different viewing options are there. And finally, data analysis and visualization. This is where we talk about pivoting, how to create a pivot, how to create a pivot chart, and how to create a regular chart, and then finally we create a dashboard. Okay, so this is what I've been talking, right from the data fundamentals to prepare a beautiful dashboard. Up to that level you will learn. Okay, right, so this course content is already there. If you want, you can download it. Okay, you can see that what all are you going to learn in this. Okay. And as I discussed here, that's only Excel. The first 4 weekends, that's Excel. Next 4 weekends, we'll talk about macros from 11 o'clock onwards, what all I'll take you through, okay? If you are here to learn only advanced Excel, you are free to leave around 11 o'clock. But if you would like to have some idea about what is a macro, what all you will learn, you know, then I'll talk about that one after 11 o'clock. Okay, so as part of this Excel course, there are a good number of test papers created. We'll share all of them with you. Okay, a few models are there. The entire package you will receive. And along with that, there are tasks, formula tasks, conditional formatting tasks and all. Okay, we'll ask you to come up with the answers for these tasks. Okay, so something like a lookup and reference task sheet. Let's say task one, a simple, you know, get the, what is Vincent's score? Where is this person is here, right? Score is 3. So simple, you know, maybe for now you may not be able to, or a few may not be able to get the answers, but, okay, if I change this to Haskell, it's 9, Loic. It's 96. So it's a VLOOKUP formula. I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, as on today, you may not be able to understand what is this formula. A few of you might have worked with this formula to fetch those values. But let me tell you one thing. We spend about 1.5 hours on formulas introduction. Once we are done with formulas introduction, you will be able to technically write any kind of a formula, be it correlation formula, standard deviation formula, covariances formula, or IRR, internal rate of return, net present value, be it any kind of formula, you will be able to write. Okay, that we discuss in the second weekend, the formulas introduction and all. So you will get some idea. Okay. All right. So these kind of tests are there, a good number of tests with you know, different real-time examples. Okay, then how to deal with it, how to get the answers and all. We also have the key papers for all these test papers. Okay, we'll share those keys also. Okay, all these tasks have been, you know, created using almost a good number of interviews, you know. When our students attended the interviews, they asked different questions, right? So using all those questions, we came up with these test papers. Okay. Right, Excel interview questions material is there, and also along with that, no Excel specifications. And a few of you are a little interested to know how many sheets can I add into our book, or what is the biggest number I can enter, or what is the minimum number I can enter into a cell, or what is the longest text content I can enter into a cell. So all those specifications are here, Excel application specifications. Okay, this material will be shared with you all. And a good number of shortcuts are there, and so many things. Okay, as we go along, I talk about so many things, you know, which are associated with Excel. Right, and the next one is about certification. Once you are done with this Excel course, okay, you can also attend Microsoft Excel certification. It's again optional one, it's up to you. But certifications, they always add some extra value to your resume. So that's the reason we talk about certifications. I'm not saying if you have certification, you will get a job. No, no guarantee. But if you have certification, then that will give you little extra edge over others. Let's say two candidates go for an interview. Both of them, they score, let's assume 9 out of 10. But one of the candidate has Microsoft Excel Specialist certification. And if that candidate says, okay, I am certified by Microsoft Excel Specialist, I'm certified as Microsoft Excel Specialist by Microsoft, that gives some additional points, right? So those, that kind of a thing you can get. I'll share this presentation with you, what we basically do and all. I think this is old presentation. We also won Urban Pro Excellence certificate for 2020 as well, ranked as number one institute in Hyderabad. Urban Pro is a professional training services platform wherein you know, a good number of institutes are there across India. Okay, so from Hyderabad location, for the last few years, we won that rank one certificate. Thank you. And it was announced in March first week, I think. Yeah. So they evaluate these things based on so many things, like student responses, student feedback, and the way the students are reaching out to us, and a number of things are there. We are also ISO certified training institute. Is there any certification for BBA? Yes, but that is still in the beta version. We haven't got any confirmation from Microsoft saying that it is now live, but you can go for Excel expert certification. There is one more level. I'm talking about Excel specialist certification now. That only covers Excel concepts. But there is another level at, you know, Excel expert certification, in which you will also get VBA. Your skill set on VBA will also be measured there. Okay. So the certification outlines and all, we can share it in your group. Once you register with us, we'll share all those details with you. And then you can decide which certification you want to go with. And we personally recommend you to first go for Excel certification. Because it sounds like if you directly go for a, you know, expert certification instead of a specialist certification, it sounds like a post-graduation without graduation, right? So we don't recommend that. You go for first specialist certification. And once you are comfortable with Excel macros and all, take some time, 3 months, 4 months, 6 months, it usually takes some time. Maybe after 6 months, you want to attend an expert certification, go for it. Okay. You can always reach out to our front office and they can guide you about the certification. Okay. So we are a group of Microsoft certified professionals, and we do a lot of different types of training programs and different tools. you know, with real-time exercises, interview questions, and so many things are there. And these are the tools we are currently offering for the training. And yeah, why get certified? I'll tell you one thing. Most of the people, they think that, you know, I completed my course, right? Then why do I need to go for certification? Few of the participants, they might get, you know, this point also into their mind. I'm already done with my course. I'm doing really good with my, you know, subject or Excel, right? Why do I still need to go for certification? This question comes because it is not a free certification. There is a 3,000 fee for it, right? If it is a free certification, anyone can, you know, easily go opt for it. But again, you know, this is an optional one. There is fee involved. Again, you will have to invest your money. That we understand. But why we strongly recommend for a certification? It's as simple as a reason, you know, this a reason being, you complete your graduation or post-graduation, right? At the end of it, what is it you do? You take a test, right? Once you successfully complete that test, you will get a certification from that university. Okay, here you go. You complete the graduation or post-graduation. You don't attend the test. You might have excellent knowledge in the subject, but if you do not attend a test to get an official recognition for your skills, then you may go out to, you know, an interview and you say that I am really great with the subject, but in that half an hour of interview time, they may not be evaluate each and everything, the entire skill set, right? You know, when we go for an interview, they ask our highest educational qualification. The highest educational qualification is only validated with the certification that we have. Yes or no? You might have attended MBA, you might have attended CA or whatsoever, but if you don't have the certification, then it is as good as you have, you don't have that skill set, right? So for that purpose only, we recommend people to go for certification because it gives you official recognition, and which is a globally valid certification offered by Microsoft, and it's not only limited to Hyderabad or India. It is global. People who travel to Canada, USA, Australia, they reach out to us before, you know, going there for this certification because it has that much value globally, right? So the certification looks like this, okay? It comes with your name here, okay? And you completed so-and-so certificate signed by Sacha Nadella, who is current CEO, and with one unique code on it. So using this unique code, companies can check your credentials, whether this person attended, you know, a few things are there. Using that code, they can check. Okay. If you are asking about expiry, does it have any valid, any, you know, date valid up to kind of a thing? If you're asking about expiry date, Ramesh, am I correct?
Yes.
Okay. Good thing is that this particular certification, you know, all technology related certifications have some validity. Okay, validity. Usually they come up with 2 years, 3 years, and after 2 years, 3 years, you will have to again renew that certificate. And again, there is some cost involved. The only one certificate in the technological world that I found which doesn't have any expiry date is Microsoft Office Special Certification. There is no expiry. Once you are certified forever. You no need to renew. I completed my certification back in 2011. It's been like 10 years, a good 10 years, right? And I'm a certified professional, that's it. No expiry for it. Good question you asked, Ramesh. No expiry. Okay, so I can share this presentation. You can go through that and you can also search about us. What are the things that we are delivering from almost like last close to 7 years, right? We are physically located in two places in Hyderabad, Amirpet and Dilshukh Nagar, but yeah, currently we are operating from Amirpet location offline, and online sessions are running from all, you know, it doesn't really matter where you sit, right? So yeah, this is basically about us and about the certification. If you are interested about certification, let you know our coordinators know about it. They will share the details, how to get registered with Microsoft and how to get, you know, how to attend the exam. It's an online examination, by the way. It's an online examination. You can come down here and you can take it. Or otherwise, you can take it from your home also. Okay, it's an online examination and 1,000 marks is the score. 1,000, right? Cutoff is 700, 70%. Most of the people, they think that usually every exam comes with either 35% right, either 35% and 40% right. Why 70% as a cutoff? If you don't get 70%, you are failed. Right? So why such a high standard in the pass percentage? Because it also offers high package. Not everyone, if it is like 35%, 40%, anyone can easily crack it. But good thing is that the ones who attend the course here, they are always like successful in achieving this certification. So no issues at all. If you attend the course completely and follow the exercises, practice it, I don't think it's like a complex one. It's very easy. Okay. These are not multiple choice questions. No. There are questions asked in this way. Please write a VLOOKUP formula for the following data or create a clustered column chart using this table. And look at the question, understand it, and answer it. That's all. Okay? It's very easy. We'll also share some material, practice test papers, model papers, and all. Just spend about 1-2 hours and you can easily do it. Examination is for 50 minutes, 50 minutes. Okay, and you get around 25 to 30 questions. Very easy to crack. That you need to do a little bit of. Yeah, any help will be required while writing exam. You often should kindly suggest. Okay, so the point is that you can reach out to our coordinators. They can share the full details with you about how to schedule your exam and by, you know, if you want to come down here and you want to take an examination from here or you want to take it from your home. You know, all those steps and all that material will be shared. Just follow those instructions, okay? And complete the registration and you can then attend the exam, okay? Okay, so the material, if you follow properly, there won't be any new things in that exam. Okay, you may not need any assistance also, right? You can all easily clear. Okay, so no need to worry about that one. We provide enough guidance and enough material to crack the exam. All right. So I hope I shared the required information about this course and how it goes, and it's a weekend batch, okay? And I also spoke about why data analytics and how we are going to use Excel in the data analytics, okay? I'll show you each and every stage, okay? I'll take you through. Let me open one of those files that I used in my last session. This is where we start. Okay, why Excel? And I take you through all those points, Excel user interface, how to customize the quick access toolbar, a good number of shortcuts, data types, how to work with numbers, how to work with clipboard. So many things are there. And once that is done, we'll move on to the formulas. This is where we work with how to create EMI tables, or how to create lookup formulas. A good number of lookup formulas are there. Okay. Right. I can show you a few today, but you know, let's keep it like only an introduction session. I don't want to take into the subject. You know, if you are you know, looking for this analysis related roles, this is the right course. Okay, that's what I just wanted to tell you. But once we enter into the subject, we'll start from the scratch of Excel. And from that point, how to go to a dashboard. Up to that level, we'll discuss. Yep. So yeah, for, see, these MIS analyst roles and all, they again depend on the different domains you are into. But wherever you go, you see the same thing. You see the data, you see numbers, you see text. How to work with them, we'll learn. Okay. Power Pivot is also covered in this course. Yes, we can cover it as a separate one, but part of this course only. We'll let you know once these 4 weekends are over. Either 5th weekend or 6th weekend, we'll take one day to show you the power pivoting concepts so that, you know, you will also get some time to practice the regular concepts, and then we'll let you know. Usually the power pivot and all, we club a couple of batches and we offer that session as one batch.
Sure.
Yeah, so that's how it runs. Okay, any questions? Yeah, coming to the material sharing, we'll upload all this material, whatever we share here. We upload all this material into Google Drive, and from there you can download, right? Most of the people think that, you know, the material that we use in the classroom, they don't share it with students. Most of the institutes, they do in that way. Because they believe that material plays a major role, right? But we believe that not the material, it's the way we deliver it that plays the role. See, I'll tell you one thing. There are so many videos on Excel, right? In YouTube. You just search for Excel, right? And thousands of videos will come. You might write basics of Excel. You just type it. Thousands of videos, they come. And it is free. Interesting, right? But why students still reach out to us? I'll tell you one simple statement here. Having so much of information is as good as having no information. Because you don't know where to start, where to end. That usually happens. You know, when you search for something, it gives you 100 different videos, but you don't know which one really helps you, right? And another thing is that the information online is scattered. One piece here, one piece there. You don't, you know, as an end user, we usually don't know how to relate or how to link those things. But in these courses, what we designed here, everything goes like a story in a flow. Okay, we talk about stage one, right? And we talk about stage two and how we can link the stage one with stage two. And it flows like that. So when something is told in a manner, like a story, we usually get connected to that subject. But in online, that possibility is not there because so much of information is there, you don't know how to connect it. That's the problem, right? But we are very much sure, because this is what we have been doing. We can share all those details with how to, you know, connect each and every topic, okay? All right, any questions? Online, any questions from you? Excel is more than enough to do any MIS reporting. Yes, because everywhere we use Excel only. Excel formulas are enough, Excel pivot tables are enough to prepare any report. Yeah, but again, if you want to go for a bit more, like a data analyst, that's when you need extra skills.
Yeah. So when is the batch is going to start, and what is plan?
I think, yeah, Divya should let you know that one. Divya, you're there? Just give me a second. Yeah, this is starting from tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and we start from Excel for the first 4 weeks, and then we move on to macros for the next 4 weeks.
So the timings would be 9 to 1, right? 9 to 1,
yes.
It's a weekend batch from tomorrow onwards. Okay. So whom to contact about the payment and other stuff?
Yeah, I'm writing in the chat window. I'm sharing a number. Just contact this number. He'll help you with the registration and all.
Okay, fine. Thanks.
Okay. So yes. Any other questions?
Macros in the sense, so next 4 weeks, that should be the VBA course, right?
Yes, that's VBA course, correct.
So in the first 4 weeks, that means, so today we covered, this week is when, apart from this week, 4 weeks are including this week with the 4 weeks?
No, today is just like an introduction session, right? So usually it takes 4 weeks, close to 26 to 30 hours, depends on the speed and the different things that we discuss. So it goes up to 1, 2, 3, 4.
Maybe if get late, it will be next month 11th.
11th, yes, correct.
Okay, and sir, so that will be continuation of VBA on the next batch as well, right? Or it will take some gap?
Same batch, VBA will also be continued.
Okay, so after, because I already intimated, say I want to be to change my role to data analytics. Mm-hmm. So as per the your explanation now, so after completion of this, the continuation will be the SQL.
Right, after that you can attend SQL and then Power BI.
So that SQL also maybe it will continue, or it will we need to wait for some to start.
No, we usually start batches every month, every couple of weeks there will be a new batch starting. So
okay, thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Sir Kishos.
Yeah. Go on, please.
So this batch will continue, right? This batch will continue for Excel, VBA, and SQL continue. It will continue, right?
Yes. SQL will have to set up, but this batch is already planned for Excel and VBA. For this coming 8 weekends, 4 weekends for Excel, 4 weekends for macros. Yeah, it's already done. It's finalized.
Okay. See, if you want to continue for Power BI also, we should have knowledge, and some SQL knowledge should be there. So for that reason, I'm asking.
Right. Today after.
See, if I continue the.
Today afternoon,
yes, sir.
Starting this, just like an awareness session is there on SQL and Power BI. If anyone is interested, attend, I think it's 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock. Just some awareness. Once you're done with that, then once you're done with Excel macros, then you can think about SQL and Power BI course.
Sir, you were telling only SQL and, you're not telling SQL and Power BI, you were telling only VBA and Advanced Excel?
I am taking only Excel and VBA, correct, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we cannot continue the parallelly continue the Excel along with the VBAs, right?
No, because once we are done with Excel, then only we can proceed to VBA. Not parallel. But if someone has already some idea about Excel, then you can parallelly continue also. But again, that may be a little extra load on you to practice on daily basis.
Mm-hmm. Okay, fine then.
Okay.
Yeah, thanks, Kishore. Thank
you. Fine then. Any other questions?
No, so my cousin recommended me for this institute because it's a great place. And it's really it's a best platform, best institute for me to learn Excel here. And I'm a big fan of Mr. Kishore sir. The way he explained is very nice. So one of my cousins, he already completed the Excel course from here.
and he got wanted in Synchrony, the multinational company. So I really waited for this course for past, you know, so many days, so many months. So I'm very glad to be part of this team and this institute and this batch. So no need to worry, guys. We are a safe place, the best place to learn and get the exposure.
Thanks for that. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you so much for the show, sir.
No problem at all. Fine then. So if you would like to have some, you know, idea about macros, you can stay back, take a quick 10 minutes break and you can come back. I'll quickly show you, you know, we can spend 1.5 hours to close to 2 hours to understand what is macro and what all are covered in the macro. But if you're
one more doubt, sir.
So then, go on,
hello. Please. Like these classes are generally for only weekends or are there any regular batch like every day in the morning or evening like that?
We also offer regular batches morning and evening times, but they are weekday batches. They run usually in the morning time 7 to 8:30, evening 7 to 8:30.
Okay.
Weekend batch are designed especially for the working professionals.
Okay, and one more doubt, like I'm a qualified chartered accountant. Is it this really VBA macros will be useful for me or SQL? I'm still not knowing what exactly those things are. What I do is generally reporting to the management, as CA can do generally. That's my job. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking to know some more things. If really those things can helpful to me in future, I'll really like to learn. But think like SQL, this coding, it looks like almost like a programming.
I agree. So let's do one thing. As I said, I'm also from non-technical background and able to deliver sessions on VBA macros. Now you think about it. Learning this one is like very easy. From my side, I can say it's very easy because I was able to learn it, I'm able to deliver the session. It sounds really easy. And the other thing is that should I really learn it or not? If that's the question, if you want to save some time. We're working a lot on Excel reporting, spending like a couple of hours every day, but by learning macros, you can turn that into quick minute job.
Actually, I know some things like till up to like VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, all the summit formulas, and to some extent, I know these tools, but still, I want to know some more things like which I don't know. Right. In future, I may be like use the old things. But only thing is like this VBA macros, maybe I may not use, but still, like I'm not knowing where to start or not.
Right. But from my side, if you need to do a lot of reporting, go for VBA.
Okay. And the PowerPoint is also covered in Advanced Excel?
No. PowerPoint is a different tool, right? Different application.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not part of it, but you can learn how to create charts and all in Excel, but you can copy the same chart and paste it in a PPT to for the presentation purpose.
And can you suggest me one more thing? Like, is it better to come to the offline session there? I'm prepared because I stay there near to that. So this will be not less than that.
So that I'll also get some motivation looking at few faces, right? It is.
Yeah, obviously it will help you and also me because I can ask directly what I really get doubts or etc.
Yeah. Batch size, we are keeping it limited only offline only. We are just thinking about 8 to 10 participants because of the current.
Yeah, understood. Yeah, no, understood.
With okay. The good distance here.
Yes.
Yeah, you can come down. You know, with just like only 4 participants offline here and we can easily accommodate 10 here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
All right. Okay. I'm ending this session. And if you would like to join the other VBA introduction session, you can join the other link. I think it's already there and we'll share this video with you for all, you know, you can find it on our YouTube video and you will also get a notification as soon as it is posted in your WhatsApp. And I'll speak with you soon. And tomorrow we are starting Excel, Advanced Excel. You know, you want to call it as Advanced Excel, call it Advanced Excel. It's up to you. Tomorrow we are starting at 9:00. Okay. Yeah, the ones who are interested to join the VBA link, it's already there with you, I believe. If not, contact that number that I shared and she will share that link with you. Okay. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.